Oh my Lord. Why are there so many right here? Okay, it is day two, and I feel like I'm a little bit more prepared for what I've got today. Now that I'm on the river, underneath the bridge, and back in the land of pike, what I decided to do is tie on a spinnerbait. The reason I did is because I think I should be able to catch pike on this without having them break it off. You know, I was throwing like Texas rigs, Ned rigs, that sort of thing. Well, the thing is, the pike is gonna absolutely mouth that entire bait, get to the line and cut it like butter. With a spinnerbait, I kind of feel like they're gonna hit the body of the spinnerbait and maybe not get the line. I guess we'll find out. That's right, folks. Today we are going for toothy river monsters. I decided the spinnerbait is absolutely a great bet because it seems like pike just crush anything with flash. What I'm really gonna do is I'm gonna key in on grass lines, but the thing is there's a ton of grass lines. So I think the main areas that I'm gonna place my focus is kind of river bends where it seems like there's a little bit more depth. And then if there's any like particular weeds that stick out or if there's a tree or something, that's where I'm really gonna hit hard. Obviously, growing up in Kansas, I did not grow up with pike. Definitely a foreign fish to me. I know one thing, when I did take a trip to Canada back in high school, I caught the tar out of them. I didn't know what I was doing back then. I just threw a big spoon and just kind of twitched it around in the shallows and they smashed it. Once I get up around this river bend, I have a feeling I'm gonna find something. There's gotta be a lot of fish back here. There's good current all through. Oh, there he is. There's our first pike of the day. That's definitely a pike. That is definitely a pike. The way it's fighting, the way it bit, that is definitely a pike. Here we go. Let's see if we can't get it to come up and do a little jump for us. Oh boy, it's just dogging me. It's actually not a bad pike. My dad's gonna be proud of me. He's been telling me to fish for these dang things. It's actually a pretty big one. Give me my net, boy. All right. Ooh, that's a river monster, boys. Give me that. Oh, barely fits in the net. If I start fishing for toothy critters more often, I'm gonna need to get me a bigger net, that's for sure. Fortunately, I got my pliers ready to rock, and I'm just gonna see if I can remove that in the net. Yes, I can. Boom shakalaka. Daggum crazy fish, man. Right there, there she is. Just a beautiful fish. I'm gonna turn her right back loose. Not a small fish, not a giant. They can get a lot bigger than that, obviously. Here in Michigan, I've never seen any true pike giants. Fish like that, I'll take any day of the week. Man, I tell you what, when you come out here with the mentality of catching pike and you do it, it feels pretty darn good. When you're chasing bass and they bite, they can be kind of a hassle. But I tell you what, I do appreciate these fish. I really do. Whew, pretty fun. Gotta be honest with you. You know what? The other thing is, this is vacation. I'm gonna reward myself with a tasty beverage. I'm normally more of a microbrew kind of guy, but I'm gonna try this Truly hard seltzer. I've actually never had a Truly in my life. I've had some White Claws, they're good. I guess we're gonna find out what a Truly tastes like. See if it's truly better. See if it's truly as good as they say. I do like the lime White Claws. I'd have to believe this will be good. Interesting, that is very limey. Quite limey indeed. The reason I knew exactly as soon as that hit that was a pike, I felt slack. Like it ticked it and I felt complete slack. And so what that really was the pike biting it and swimming towards me. They have like a very unique bite. Feels very different than a bass usually. They smack it and just run right at you. They're just renegade, crazy freaking monsters, man. This whole thing is just a big swampland, man. I did not know water existed like this in this neck of the woods. If you're new to spinnerbaits, one thing you can do is add a trailer hook, and that's actually a good thing I did because that fish actually had the trailer hook. Here, pikey, pikey, pikey. Oh, oh, something hit it, something hit it. There he is. Oh, got him. He came back for it. I wonder if this is the same fish I caught yesterday on 2 pound test. No, it's definitely smaller, definitely smaller. Oh my gosh. See, these fish are just absolutely insane. This tiny pike just going for the spinnerbait like it's nobody's business. I am going to try to avoid some tiny little pike teeth in my hand. So let's see if we can't get out my pliers here, old trusty pliers. And we're just gonna turn him loose like so. There you go, buddy. You know me, you know, just team dink for life. Just an absolute dinky pike. Man, I could fish this river 12 straight hours and not even scratch the surface. I might need to put up the drive system. We're getting really grassy right here. So this morning, I actually spent the entire morning on a beach, Crystal Lake in Michigan. And I tell you what, if you're looking for a good place to vacation, Crystal Lake is unbelievable. I don't know what the heck to expect in an area like this, but oh my Lord, there he is. Oh my gosh, he came after it. Oh my gosh, these fish are nuts, man. Oh my gosh. Oh, he's dangerous. He bit it in a dangerous fashion. I didn't know what to expect right here, I was just getting ready to say. And then this guy comes out of nowhere and throttles it. He misses it the first time, and now he's got it deep down his throat. See what we can do without getting hooked here. I might be a weenie, but I don't want to deal with this pike's teeth. Boom! See that little gator right there? See ya, buddy. I've probably got a little pike juice in my Truly. Honestly, still tastes good. Do pike like, you know, like flooded timber and stuff like that? There's a lot of trees, but I have yet to catch any pike off of them. I feel like they totally like vegetation a lot more than like flooded timber. How about a little update from the water? I'm having a blast today. I did not expect to have so much fun chasing pike, but man, three fish in, we're fishing this absolutely super cool spot. I've said it a couple times now. This totally reminds me of the Mississippi River in La Crosse, Wisconsin. It's just a jungle. It's beautiful. It's perfect weather right now too, which is making things excellent. I don't know, I'm rambling right now. All I'm saying is I'm having a blast out here, and I would highly recommend chasing pike if you have them in your area. I need to do a better job of chasing pike more often because they are a fun fish, and I want to show that to the world on YouTube. So what I'm going to do is keep catching some today, hopefully, and you can count on me to fish for them again in the future because they are a cool fish and they deserve some internet love. Okay, let's get back to it. Here's the question. You can make your prediction now if you want. Am I gonna randomly run into a largemouth bass today? To me, it would be so silly to think that we're not gonna find a random bass. I'm actually gonna bet no. I genuinely don't think this is a good largemouth factory, which is crazy because if I was a largemouth, I would absolutely love it here. Wait a second. No. I think I got the trailer hook out of his mouth, but I think it just fell in the water. I should oh, there he is. Without the trailer hook, he's got it, baby. Oh boy. Oh boy, it's just a little guy. Just a little guy, but they fight so dang hard, man. Holy snag, oh my gosh. Chill, boy. What is with this? Oh, this one had like a lamprey on it for sure. You see that big gouge in him? He definitely had a lamprey on him. He don't anymore. You little stink. Dude, that is why I get scared of him. Honestly, I think he's just biting my hook at this point. There you go. Hmm. The rest of the juice goes to the pike. As a reminder, never throw your cans in the water. I cannot emphasize that enough. We need to respect the ecosystems of the fish that we all love so much. Man, I love it here. Dude, I would totally like to fish this river more in the future. I bet there's gotta be, oh my Lord, these fish. I'm just like chilling, scratching my mustache, man. This one just dogs it. Oh my gosh. Just a noodle, man. It's a slimy, wet, pikey noodle, man. Holy cannoli. These fish are insane. Look at that fish. Just such a cool fish. They're just total predators, man. They're crazy. They are wild, man. If you're gonna learn something from today's video, it's like, if you come across a pike that's found his way on land and decided that he wants to go to your local bar, I would leave immediately. You're gonna get in a tussle with him and he's gonna win. That's all I'm saying. Pike are, they're wild, man. Oh my gosh, there's another. Freaking throttled it. It's the land of the pike. Oh, he ditched it. Honestly, that's okay. I probably should be using a trailer hook, but I'm doing okay without. I don't care. He throttled it. He was a little bigger than the last couple, but he wasn't as big as the first one we caught. So I'm not that mad that I missed him. He got down to that grass and he shook it free. Oh my Lord! Why are there so many right here? Why are there's three consecutive casts. My gosh. No, oh, I missed him. He was a much fatter fish. What is going on? My spinnerbait's getting toasted. Look at this spinnerbait. Just they're just murdering this. There's a difference in how a pike hits a bait versus how a bass hits it. A bass hits it because it wants to eat it. It, you know, it's gonna hit it aggressively. A pike hits it because it wants to absolutely ruin the day of that bait fish as well as every other bait fish in the area. It wants to show that it is the absolute alpha male of the area. And it's just, it makes fishing for them insane. And so I cannot help my reactions. They're just a crazy freaking fish, man. I gotta be honest with you. I've only got one more trailer hook and it's on another spinnerbait and I am having the hardest time trying to get off. I also brought one more Truly, which I feel like I owe to myself. I also worked my way back up river so I can fish that same stretch where I got multiple bites. I think something's kinda fiddling with it. Oh! Oh my gosh! These fish are freaking insane! Oh my god! Okay, I need to pike fish more. Every time I do it, man, I fall in love a little bit. I knew something was chasing it. I kept feeling these little tinks. It was just coming up and tink, tink, and I'm like, that ain't grass, man, that's a fish. And then I just killed my bait. And all of a sudden, this guy comes out of nowhere and murders it, dude. Holy crap, pike are the most mean fish in the universe, dude. I am impressed thoroughly with this guy right here. You, sir, are a freaking alpha male. I love you. See ya, dude. Respect. Whew. The hook's bent. The wire is just turnt. But she's holding up. All right. I got to give her credit. Oh, my gosh. There he is. There he is. Small fish. Why are they all pike? It's all pike. Okay, there he got off. Literally like a 9-inch pike there. Small one. This river is just pike river. I think that last pike I caught gets the most exciting fish catch award of 2020 so far. Oh! Yeah, I mean, it was the loudest I've laughed fishing in quite some time. Like I said, I really haven't gotten any bites by timber, so I don't know if I'll get any. Oh, there, changed it. This one was by some trees. Just a little guy though, little guy. A wild fish, man, a real wild fish. See you, buddy, go back. All right, okay. There's a lot, oh, there he is. There's a lot of water back here. That's what I was thinking, is like, there's gotta be fish back here. There's a lot of water. Just a little gator. All right, buddy. Let's see if we can grab you without the net. Okay, I gotta use nets, man. These fish are just too crazy. Okay, chill. All right, let's just do one of these. There you go, buddy. Okay, so I made my way back to this backwater section right here. Just an absolute jungle. And overall, all I gotta say is, man, this is really just a fisherman's paradise. There's so much water to be broken down, and the reality is probably a good portion of it is unproductive. That being said, who doesn't love to just explore a big river system like this? It's gorgeous, it's beautiful. Even if the fish weren't biting, I'd be having a good time, but fortunately for me, the pike are going nuts. I don't know, man. All I gotta say is I'm having a good day, and I'm loving it. There's a little plane right above me, and you can probably hear him, can't you? I am going to just sit here for a second, just take it all in, and then I'm gonna get back to fishing. Let's go. I've just been sitting here for a couple minutes, just relaxing. It's just cool. It's like, it's so still back here, even though it's windy. This is so protected because, like I said a thousand times, it's essentially a freaking jungle back here. So I can just sit here, relax, sip this Truly, and just enjoy life, man. Am I in the Everglades or am I in Michigan? I'm honestly confused. Well, I turned off the cameras for a split second, and what do you know? Another pike came and absolutely dogged my spinnerbait. Oh my gosh, can you not? All right, see you, buddy. All right, okay. I turned off my cameras, and then he just smoked my spinnerbait. Oh my lord! Right in front of the kayak. They're little missiles, man. Once they get hooked, they just shoot around. Just a little guy, but golly, they are little missiles, dude. God made these fish wild, I'll tell you that much. There you go, buddy. Ultimately, I think the moral of the story for today is that I had a plan. I came out here thinking, I'm gonna fish the lake, I'm gonna throw a drop shot, I'm gonna throw a light line, and I'm gonna catch smallmouth bass. Well, obviously that has not been the case. And I came here, I found myself in a situation where it's river, it's really completely the opposite of the fishing style that I wanted to do. And rather than complain about it, get frustrated about it, what I did is I kept a positive attitude and I catered to the situation. I tied on a spinnerbait and I embraced the toothy critters. And ultimately, I gotta be honest with you, I've had more fun by doing so. I have realized today, one, that I really, really do like pike. And two, I really learned about pike. I've learned how they set up, how they bite, what they like, what they don't like, and I'm a better fisherman because of that. This is an absolutely different experience than I've ever had as a fisherman, and I can't be more thankful for it. So I guess what I'm saying is, you know, always try to make the most of your situation. There's no sense in just getting negative and frustrated. It's okay to be negative. Like, I am negative. I was frustrated for a minute there, but I decided, let's turn that around, let's focus on the positives, and let's just make the most of our situation. If you try to make the most out of your situation, you're probably gonna have a great time. As much fun as the seltzers were, it's time for a water. It's about time to get back to the family and clean up, get ready for dinner. Oh my gosh. What is this? So I hooked into a rock bass and he got me behind something and I thought I was snagged. And then I got him out from underneath it and yeah, caught a rock bass. All right, well, it isn't an online outdoorsman video without an ed rig catch. So now that we got that done, I guess it's time to head in. Okay, I just got back from today's trip and I gotta be honest with you, I had so much more fun than I expected. I didn't realize I'd catch that many pike. I figured I'd catch like 3 or 4. Well, I absolutely hammered them. If you wanna see me fish for more pike in the future, make sure to let me know in the comments below because I'm totally for it. It's a lot of fun and honestly, I guess I just never really think to do it. Aside from that, stay tuned for more videos in this mini series. I'm not entirely sure how many more there will be, but I'm hoping for at least 1 or 2 more. I'm just kind of going with the flow, man. I'm on vacation. I'm not a full-time YouTuber, so I can't really plan all this stuff out. I'm just kind of going with the flow. I hope you understand. Regardless, thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.